Robert Mueller is looking at Ivanka Trump's interaction with Russian lawyer during infamous meeting at Trump Tower. Ivanka Trump's contact with a Russian attorney and a lobbyist during the infamous June 2016 Trump Tower meeting is reportedly coming under the microscope of special counsel Robert Mueller's investigation. The president's daughter reportedly came into contact with Russian lawyer Natalia Veselnitskaya and the lobbyist Renat Akhmetshin while they were exiting the building during a brief elevator ride. A person familiar with the encounter told the Los Angeles Times that while the exchange consisted of pleasantries, investigators want to know every interaction Trump's family members and inner circle had with them. The report also says that one participant in the meeting with a Kremlin-connected attorney has been recalled for questioning. It is believed that Mueller's focus specifically on President Trump's misleading claim that the meeting had to do with Russian adoption, and not with the goal of obtaining damaging information on Hillary Clinton, could indicate that investigators are looking at obstruction of justice by the president and several close advisers, as opposed to collusion with the Russians. The meeting, during the height of the presidential race, was between his eldest son, Donald Trump Jr., his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, and his campaign manager, Paul Manafort, along with Veselnitskaya and Akhmetshin. The Russian language translator, the U.S.-based employee of a Russian real estate group, and a British music promoter with Russian business ties, were also in attendance. President Trump said Saturday that everything I've done is 100% proper regarding the special counsel's investigation of Russian meddling in the 2016 U.S. election, and he insisted that his campaign didn't collude with Moscow or commit any crime. His team has been open with special counsel Robert Mueller and done nothing wrong, Trump told reporters at Camp David on Saturday, where he was meeting with Republican congressional leaders and cabinet members to discuss legislative strategy in the new year. He'd moaned the unrelenting focus on alleged Russia ties, saying the probe is very, very bad for our country. It's making our country look foolish, and this is a country that I don't want looking foolish, and it's not going to look foolish as long as I'm here. The number of news outlets, including the Associated Press, have reported that Trump directed his White House counsel to tell Attorney General Jeff Sessions not to withdraw from the Justice Department's investigation into potential ties between Russia and the Trump campaign. Sessions' decision to step away prompted Mueller's appointment. Trump told reporters at Camp David that the New York Times story first reporting the request was way off, or at least off, though he wouldn't say how. He added, "Everything that I've done is 100% proper. That's what I do, is I do things properly." Despite his anger over Sessions' withdrawal from the investigation, Trump said he stands by the embattled Sessions, the vocal and loyal supporter of his election bid. The investigation into possible coordination between the Trump campaign and Russia already includes a close look at whether Trump's actions as president constitute an effort to impede that investigation. Those actions include the firing of FBI Director James Comey, an allegation by Comey that Trump encouraged him to end an investigation into former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn and the president's role in drafting an incomplete and potentially misleading statement about a 2016 meeting with Russians. The latest revelation, that Trump directed White House counsel Donegan to tell Sessions not to step aside from the Russia investigation, is known to Mueller's investigators, who have interviewed many current and former executive branch officials. Three people familiar with the matter confirmed to the Associated Press that McGinn spoke with Sessions just before he announced his recusal to urge him not to do so. One of the people said McGinn contacted Sessions at the president's behest. All three spoke on condition of anonymity to avoid publicly discussing an ongoing investigation. It remains unclear whether Mueller's team has evidence to establish that the president's collective actions were done with the corrupt intent needed to prove obstruction of justice. Trump and his lawyers have repeatedly maintained that he did nothing improper and that, as president, he had unequivocal authority to fire Comey and to take other actions. They may also argue that the president was empowered to want the attorney general he appointed to oversee the Justice Department's Russian meddling investigation or, as McGinn contended to Sessions, that there was no basis or reason at that time for the attorney general to recuse himself. In stepping aside from the probe on March 2, Sessions said it was not appropriate for him to oversee any investigation into a campaign of which he was an active supporter. Though the recusal also followed the revelation that he had had two previously undisclosed interactions during the 2016 campaign with the Russian ambassador to the United States. At his January confirmation hearing, He had said he had had no meetings with Russians. Sessions' recusal left Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein in charge of the Russia investigation. But once Trump fired Comey 2 months later, Rosenstein appointed Mueller, the former FBI director, to run the investigation and to report to him. Four people, including Flynn and Trump's former campaign chairman, have been charged so far in the investigation.